So how do you find money from your house and then pull it and use it for something else? Happy Monday. We're here again with Chris's Corner every week, going live, talking about some real estate related questions that we get. So how do you find money in your house and use it for different ways or whatever? Let's say you're in a pickle, something happened and you need to use a big chunk of money. Maybe you're trying to pay off school debt, maybe whatever reason, and you needed some money. Or maybe you're deciding you want to buy another property, maybe a rental property, which would be a great thing to do in this case. Or three, maybe you need some money because you want to update the kitchen, you want to buy a car, you want to go on vacation, whatever. It's your money. You can do whatever you want. I would not suggest pulling out money from your house for number three for just spending it, but it's your money. Do whatever you want with it. It's up to you. But let's say you need to get a good chunk of money for whatever reason. What can you do if you do own a property and you've had it for a couple years at least in this market, honestly, maybe even 6 months. But if you have a property, what can you do if you need some extra money? There are two ways where you can pull money from your house without selling it. You want to stay there, you want to keep the home, but you need access to the money in it because of how much the market has appreciated the past couple years. So the most common way we see people do that is doing a cash out refinance. So you've probably heard the term refinance before, where people will refinance their mortgage loan in order to get a different interest rate. Now, a cash out refinance basically means not only are you refinancing your loan for the current interest rate, but you're gonna pull some money out of it and you're gonna use it for whatever you want. You can go on a spending spree at the mall, which I would, please don't do that. Please don't do that. If you're gonna do it for a rental property, I'm gonna cheer you on. If you do it for other things that are not productive, if you're not buying, then maybe you might get into trouble. But if you need to pull money out, cash out refinance is the top thing that people do when they do need money in a bind. And typically the way it works is most banks, you can only get about 70% of the equity in your home. So let's say you own a home that's, $300,000, right? You're only going to be able to get a mortgage up to $210,000. So let's say an example, let's say you have a $300,000 home, you owe about 100K on that mortgage from when you bought it, whenever you bought it. If you wanted to pull cash out and you wanted to buy a new property, you wanted to do some fixes, whatever, you could technically, from that 100K mortgage, you can pull out $100,000 at the very least in a cash out refinance. So you have access to 100K in cash within 2 months if you wanted to, for whatever reason. So that's how cash out refinances work. Now, keep in mind, you're going to need to do it in the current interest rate. So not a lot of people are going to be fans of doing it right now. A ton of people did it a couple years ago when interest rates were at 2.5, at 3%. A bunch of people are doing it now. We might not see that too much. Now, the second way, it's a great mention, Chris, is HELOCs. Home equity lines of credits are the second biggest way people use to access the money in their house. Thanks for the tip. So the reason why people would do this is because they have a good interest rate. Maybe they don't want to refinance out of the current interest rate that they have. For example, in the market that we're in, if you got an interest rate at 3.5, 3%, and you don't want to refinance your loan, but for whatever reason, you want to have access to the money in your house, you can do a HELOC. So HELOCs are typically kind of like credit cards on your house. That's a kind of a good way to put it. Let's say every bank's going to be a little bit different, but it's going to be sort of a revolving credit line on your house that you're going to have a different interest rate for depending on what bank you have. Some banks, hey, maybe you have a 100K mortgage and your bank will give you a 50K revolving line of credit on your house, a home equity line of credit on your house. That means you're going to have not only the mortgage for 100K, but whenever you do pull out money from a HELOC, you're going to have basically a second mortgage on the property. It's not considered a mortgage, but you're going to have a second line of credit off your property that you're going to owe. So think of it's going to be different terms, different interest rate. You still keep the first mortgage, but you have this added HELOC on your second home that you're going to continually use and pay off if you do use it. The great thing is you can always kind of ask a bank for this without ever having to use it, and you don't really have any issues with it. So just in case emergencies happen, you can always have this access line of credit to your house without ever refinancing, without ever doing anything, which is a great benefit to it. So those are really the top two ways that you can access the money in your house and use it. You got a cash out refinance, which will change your interest rate, but you have access to money that you can do whatever you want with it. Or you can do a HELOC, home equity line of credit, which will keep your first mortgage, and you'll have this credit line on your house that you're gonna have to pay back at a different interest rate depending on what bank you use and depending on what amounts they let you. So those are the top two ways that you can pull money out of your house. So if you have any issues, you have any questions, let me know. Definitely 100% would absolutely recommend doing this if you want to buy a rental property, because you're using the money from your first property to buy a second one, which is amazing, and it is the power of real estate that is so lovely that I've done it before. Many people have done it before, and is a great way to grow your wealth. If you're doing it for going on vacation, it's your money. Maybe you want to enjoy life a little bit. Hey, go at it. Just be conscious of what you're getting into if you do that. So hopefully you had a great Monday and you guys are excited for this week. If you have any other questions, send me a message and we'll make sure to answer them next week on Chris's Corner. Otherwise, hope you guys are having an amazing Monday and we will catch you next week.